who here has the honor and the privilege of presenting Alexis for this ceremony of marriage. Thank you, sir. Be seated. Now, you should know that I had a little trouble putting together this ceremony, and you know, most of you know Alex is not a real traditional kind of guy, so the, you know, dearly beloved Adam is not a real traditional kind of guy. He's very happy-go-lucky, kind of easygoing, dry wit. He didn't want that, you know, dearly beloved, we're gathered, no candle lighting, no dove release, no butterfly, wild boars. No, it turns out you need a permit for those, so I couldn't do that. So anyway, I made some notes, and I hope it works, so we'll see. All right, ready? First of all, family and friends, Adam and Alexis welcome you. Each of you are important and special people in their lives, and they would like you to know that your friendship, your love, and your encouragement will always be appreciated. It is fitting, then, that you should be here today on this very beautiful day, on this very special day, to help celebrate and to be a witness to the joining together of their two lives in marriage. Now, each of you is a friend which together have woven the tapestry of Adam and Alexis's time, their tapestry of their lives, I guess you could say. You've woven the tapestry of their lives. It's a symbolic thing. This is the fabric that they wrap around themselves and take comfort in when the world seems cold. And on days like today, when everything is right, that tapestry proudly is spread out and displayed with all the glorious colors and textures that represent the support from each of you. So what I'm trying to say here is that each of you hold a very special place in their hearts reserved for those special people that they treasure as their friends. Now, marriage, of course, is the best and the most important relationship that can exist between a man and a woman. The construction of their love and their trust into a single growing energy of spiritual life. Marriage is a moral commitment that requires and deserves daily attention. Those of you who are married know it's not always easy to be married. Some days it's easier, some days it's harder, but it's something you have to work at every single day. And marriage deepens and enriches every facet of life. Happiness is fuller, memories are fresher, commitment is stronger. Even emotions are felt a little more strongly sometimes in marriage, but at the same time they pass away more quickly because you love each other. Marriage understands and forgives the many mistakes that life simply is unable to avoid. Those little mistakes that we all make in our lives, of course, we make mistakes from time to time because we're human, but again, you'll be quick to forgive each other, again, because you love each other. It is said that to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time for mourning and a time for dancing, a time for love. And of course, this is Adam and Alexis' time for love as they begin today on the many, many seasons that they will experience together in their new life and marriage. Now, I'm sure I don't have to tell these two that the surest basis for a successful marriage is friendship, simple friendship. Be best friends. But I have it on good authority, and most of you know that in fact they are best friends. And once again, those of you who are married know how important that is. To be best friends with your partner, it's very important, isn't it? The sharing of your common interests and the ability to discuss ideas together and to understand and appreciate each other's thoughts and dreams is also vitally important. And marriage, as I said, is a moral commitment, intensely personal, but freely given. And this commitment is made not to bind nor to give either one of you possession of the other, but to allow freedom of expression as the merging of your two lifestyles and individual personalities begin. We must remember that love comes to us as a gift, and we must work within the discipline that that demands. So today, along with the joy and the newness of your marriage, you must also recognize that you have to face forces that can divide you. Remember that love is dynamic and could fly away from a marriage that becomes static and unbending. Once again, it requires and deserves daily attention. Always strive within your marriage to respect and appreciate each other's thoughts and dreams. Dedicate yourselves to anticipating and meeting each other's emotional needs. We all have emotional needs, even guys have emotional needs, and they're very, very important. And never forget the many wonderful and fundamental qualities that each of you possess. Those basic qualities that caused you to fall in love in the first place and have brought you here today in front of your family and your friends to get married. Because those basic qualities that you love and admire about each other so much, those fundamental qualities that define who you are, they're going to change very little in your lifetime. Basically, you're going to be the same people that you are today in 5 years and in 10 years and on throughout the rest of your life. So remember that spark of excitement and happiness that you had when you were dating and that feeling of love in your hearts today, and keep it alive. Sustain it. Nourish it. And of course, Adam and Alexa sustained harmony and success in their marriage depends in no small part on each of you here this afternoon. For they will continue to depend on your love and your support. Finally, the last piece of advice that I have to give this young couple is probably the most important advice I could ever give to people contemplating marriage. Once again, those of you who are married know what I'm talking about, and these guys do as well because we talked about it. What is it, Adam? That's right. It's to always be honest with each other. Always be honest with each other. Share your hopes, share your dreams, and work together to achieve them. Share your fears, things you're uncomfortable with, things that make you crazy. Share those too, and work together to overcome them. Believe in each other and in your love and in your future together. Would you hold the flowers for him? All right, Adam, I need you to take a deep breath. I have a really important question to ask you, and you know what it is. Adam, is it your intention to choose this woman, Alexis, to be your honored and cherished wife, to live together in the state of matrimony? Do you promise to care for her and to respect her and to be her companion and her friend and forsaking all others to be faithful to her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Same question for you, my dear. Is it your intention to choose this gentleman, Adam, to be your honored and cherished husband, to live together in the state of matrimony? Do you promise to care for him and to respect him and to be his companion and his friend and forsaking all others to be faithful to him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Yeah, we go. All right, why don't you reach out and hold onto each other's hands, sort of feel... There you go. Sort of feel the energy flow between. Ooh, loosen that grip there. Ooh, easy. That's good. All right. And, Adam, look into those big handsome eyes in front of you and repeat after me. I, Adam, take you, Alexis.
I, Adam, take you, Alexis.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer and poorer.
For richer and for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In sadness and in joy.
In sadness and in joy.
Forsaking all others.
Forsaking all others.
To share together forever.
To share forever together.
Perfect. Almost.
And Alexis, look into those handsome eyes in front of you. And repeat after me. Adam, I take you as my husband.
Adam, I take you as my husband.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
I promise to be your true and loyal friend.
I promise to be your true and loyal friend.
And to put your happiness above everything.
And to put your happiness above everything.
I do this because I love you today.
I do this because I love you today.
I will love you tomorrow.
I will love you tomorrow.
And I will always love you.
I will always love you.
All right. Do we have rings? John, the rings? All right. Adam, we're going to have you go first very carefully. Place Alexis's ring on her finger. Let's turn her hands so everybody can see. Hold onto her hand. Again, look into her eyes. Repeat after me. Alexis, I give you this ring.
Alexis, I give you this ring.
And with it, I give you all of my love.
And with it, I give you all of my love.
This ring is symbolic.
This ring is symbolic.
Of all that's in my heart today.
Of all that's in my heart today.
And when you wear it.
And when you wear it.
Know that I will always love you.
Know that I will always love you.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Got it.
Flip his hand over. All right. Alexis, carefully place Alex's ring on his finger. Hold onto his hand. Look into his eyes. Repeat. After me, Alex, I give you this ring.
Adam, I give you this ring.
I'm getting that. Adam, I give you this ring.
Adam, I give you this ring.
And with it, I give you all of my love.
And with it, I give you all of my love.
This ring is symbolic.
This ring is symbolic.
Of all that's in my heart today.
Of all that's in my heart today.
And when you wear it.
And when you wear it.
Know that I will always love you.
Know that I'll always love you.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Kind of done, huh? Yeah. All right. Very well. Inasmuch as Adam and Alexis have consented together to marriage before all of you, have pledged their lives and declared their unity, by the authority vested in me, I pronounce that they are husband and wife. Adam, you know what to do. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great honor and privilege to introduce you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Adam and Alexis Bateman.